up, everybody? I'm Evie Star here with Motionless White. Guys, how are you feeling today at RockVille?
Fantastic.
Yeah, wait, have you guys haven't played yet, huh?
No.
Thank goodness, because I want to see you guys again. This year has been crazy for you guys. It's just like been a big boom. How does it feel to just go from just straight up like that?
I don't think any of us have really kind of taken it in yet.
It hasn't felt like a straight shot up.
Yeah.
It's been a work in progress for a while.
Well, you guys have some really killer songs. I mean, one of my favorites is America.
Cool.
I'm bad with titles, but when I hear them, I'm like, oh yeah, that's it. So I apologize that I can't think of any more of the names
right now
because it's sunny and my brain's fried a little.
Yeah.
You guys are doing all the major festival tours this year, right?
I think so.
And are you going on a tour of your own?
Tour.
Yeah.
Hi.
We're doing a Warped Tour this summer.
And very cool.
That's about as far as we can talk into the future.
Matt plans for more production coming soon then?
Potentially.
Yeah, we'll see what happens.
Yeah.
Cool. Got to keep it that secretive, huh?
Yeah.
I gotcha. All right. That's all right. I'll wait on pins and needles then. And so, I mean, it's going to be very uncomfortable,
yeah,
but
yeah.
I'll wait. No, I'm kidding.
Hey, it's the same for us too. We're waiting.
Well, can you at least tell me, is it going to like have a similar feel as the last album? Is it going to be more progressive?
It's about this much of the last album.
Yeah.
Right on.
It's heavier in a completely different way.
Yeah.
Very, very cool.
So it's very more mature and we're all looking forward to.
You guys have definitely evolved a lot in a year. How do you feel that you've evolved in your careers this year?
I don't know. I think that being on tour all the time and seeing other bands and seeing what other people are doing have kind of shaped the way that we think about what we want to do and the next steps that we want to take.
And, what we want to stay away from.
Yeah.
Everything.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Sometimes those are the best lessons that when you learn what not to do.
Yeah. So
what are some of the lessons that you've learned, like the funnier ones about what not to do?
I don't know if
obviously,
we can go.
Like, say on tour buses, you know, there's no number two rule.
Yeah.
Like, gotta be something.
I don't know. I can't think off the top of my head.
Okay, then tell me something interesting about you guys that nobody knows about each one of you. Do you have, like, a secret video game obsession? Do you like clubs, draw, paint,
and we all like hockey.
Hockey?
Yeah.
Who's your favorite teams?
Penguins.
Penguins?
Yep.
Very cool.
Not the Flyers. Fuck the Flyers.
Our singer likes the Flyers.
Oh,
and
boy.
The Lightning.
So yeah, hockey games probably get pretty interesting on your bus,
it's
huh?
It's the playoffs right now, so everyone's getting nuts.
You guys getting loud in there, just screaming at the TV?
Uh-huh.
I like it. Very cool.
Yeah.
What's your favorite part about hockey? The hockey or the fights?
I gotta go for the fights.
I think I would go.
They're
for
few
that
and
too.
Far between, but it's
wasn't
worth the wait.
Wasn't there one recently that everybody on every team got into a fight? I don't know what team it was, but it was like both teams, every player except the goalies.
Last year, during the playoffs, it's mainly when like the series gets tied up and both teams are just fucking pissed that they have to keep going, so they just come at each other.
I just remember hearing it on the news about how every single player on both teams was fighting at the same time. I'm like, that's weird, but right on. Well, guys, I just wanted to do a short little interview with you because I am a fan and I appreciate you guys' music and your talent and everything like that. I want to have you pick out of my little magic bag of random topics real quick, and then I will say goodbye.
Let's do it.
I'm ready. Oh, there's a little magic bag. Martha Stewart.
I talked about
Martha Stewart.
I have no idea, but I do know that that's what she
didn't.
Picked.
Didn't she make?
I didn't pick these cards.
She went to jail for insider trading.
She did.
Yeah.
Didn't she also make? Oh no, that was Paula Deen. Thinking about the whole racist
thing. Oh yeah, she called someone the N-word like 20 years ago.
Yeah.
No, Marcia Stewart was getting inside trade tips.
Yeah.
She's like the mom of the.
Can I say that?
What?
For my topic.
Yeah,
what are you going to ask us?
It's not, I'm asking you. Just talk about Martha Stewart, anything your feelings about her.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, Martha Stewart, she's a criminal. She went to She went to jail for insider trading on the stock market.
That's it.
Fuck her furniture line and all that shit. She's a bad person.
I got pride, which is very vague.
You don't have any.
Well, some of those are because they were the seven deadly sins, and that's why they got put in the man. So, which do you feel like it's a good thing to have a lot of pride, or is there a difference between arrogance and cocky?
I think there's a certain level that there is that you should maintain, you know, to I guess motivate yourself to, you know, be better and do better and all that kind of stuff. But at the same time, once you cross that threshold, you turn into an egotistical dick, and you know then.
And unfortunately, we see that happen all too much in this world, and I appreciate the fact that you guys are down to earth and very cool about everything, because you just seem like laid-back guys. We're just like, we're just walking
we're
around
playing.
And
yeah, we're
living in the
here
moment.
To play our fucking music and do our jobs.
Hey.
Just hang out.
It's a good thing. I mean, because like I said, I actually got to interview a couple of you guys last year, and this year it's great to see you back on the lineup and get to see how far you've come within that year. So for me, it's like watching a kid grow almost, you know? It's like, look how far they've come.
Last year I also had super long hair.
Yeah, a bunch of you guys, I think everybody had long hair last year.
Yeah. You still got it?
I remember asking one of you, and I had to laugh at this, please don't get mad at me, but I asked one of you what made you guys different from every other band, and one of you answered me the way we look.
I mean, it wasn't me.
I know you guys have a separate image, but I was kind of trying to, I guess it was my fault because I didn't phrase it correctly.
Yeah.
Because what I meant was what in your music elements separates you from other bands, like what makes Motionless like music unique and different from everybody else. So it's my fault for not phrasing it correctly, but it was funny when I watched the playback. I was like, did that just happen?
So, yeah, that's a weird, all right.
Just weird trivia.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's about it, guys. I just wanted to say thank you for the time and good luck on the tours. And I can't wait to hear about this secret new record you guys have possibly coming up or whatever. And,
cool. It's called Reincarnate.
Yeah.
September 16th.
Oh, you guys are allowed to talk about it.
Yeah.
I thought you were talking about tours.
Oh, no. I meant anything.
Oh, no. I mean, we can talk about the album.
Well, so then
That's about it.
And it comes out when? June 16th, you said?
September 16th.
September 16th. Damn, see, I'm trying to already, like, up it in my brain. Like, come on, no, come out now. And it is called what again?
Reincarnate.
Yes. This one is obviously going to be very different from the other one.
That's a question for our singer, if you're going to ask where it came
from.
I'm
not going to, because I know he's a lyricist.
I got the answer.
Okay.
He's got the answer.
For where the name came from? Well, because the album is so different, but at the same time it still has that element of, you know, our roots and where we came from originally. So it's kind of like everything about us and our look and our music and everything has kind of been reincarnated into this new thing.
Well, I am definitely dying to hear it. Can we expect some like singles to come out to buy before the album drops?
Yeah, I imagine during the summer.
Yes.
I don't know when.
We'll be playing a new song on Warped with Chris. Said that in another previous interview.
Oh, so good. You're allowed to say that. That's very cool.
Yeah.
Damn, I hope I get to see you on Warped then so I can at least hear the new song before it drops.
Cool.
Well, guys, thank you so much for
absolutely.
Your time.
Thank
it's
you.
Been a pleasure, and enjoy the rest of this beautiful
you.
Day. You guys have to autograph that for me because that's my way of feeling special.
Okay.
This is Motionless in White, everybody, at RockVille 2014. Latest.
See ya.